Coming up on FT, designer, actor, and...
JFK Jr.'s Hollywood Love Connection. Next on E! News Weekend, John's female link to Tinseltown and the time he brought Madonna home to meet Mom.
It didn't go over well with Jack.
Then, we'll show you where you can hobnob with the stars.
That's going to work.
Oh, wait.
Sorry about that.
Oh, no. I'm just... Don't worry about it. Okay, wait. Yeah. This is gonna...
Can you hear them now?
Yeah.
Move it right inside the door.
Hello, Lisa.
Hi, Steve.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
Pretty good.
Just pretty good?
Well, yeah. That's about as excited as... That's about as good as I get. Pretty good. I'll be better in 12 minutes. Charlize Theron's not only attractive, there's an understatement, make that beautiful, she's adaptable too, and the latest InStyle describes the actress as chameleon-like because of her ability to change her look with ease. The magazine's senior correspondent, Lisa Simpson, is in our newsroom with more. Lisa.
Hi, Steve.
Hi.
Charlize has gone from blonde to brunette to redhead, and she always looks great. She's just as easy about fashion and makeup, and that's why she's a natural for our Beauty Transformation Report.
I'm wearing Giorgio Armani. This is Celine, and the skirt is Dolce & Gabbana.
Always in the know about fashion, Charlize Theron's an actress top designers like to dress. But she prefers the simple approach.
You know, you just put something on, you feel good in it, and then you go, okay, this is it.
Her style has often been compared to the glamour of old Hollywood, and Charlize credits some of her movie roles with helping to create that image.
I think if we didn't have fashion, we wouldn't have the fashion that we have from the 20s and the 30s and the 50s and the 60s. I mean, that's beautiful stuff to look at.
Put your arm around me. Just cuddle and hug and, you know.
Charlize made an impression with her period fashions and Cider House Rules, and she also makes a stylish impact in her upcoming films, The Yards and The Legend of Bagger Vance.
Costumes and makeup and hair and your surroundings, those are all elements that play into the character, definitely. You have to be aware of them.
Charlize's hair is the focus of beauty transformation in the latest InStyle magazine. In the issue, we see her starting from 1993, her copper cut in 1998, last year's dark hair, and the glamour stew at this year's Oscars. Theron's stylist says when it comes to the young actress's look, it's all about how she wants to play that day. And she always prefers the light touch when it comes to makeup.
Put on some makeup, and I add a glass of champagne.
Charlize certainly understands all the nuances of style because...
actors are very sensitive people.
People who've done Charlize's makeup say it takes very little time because she's so beautiful.
I'd have to agree with that. You know, I saw her at the Cannes Film Festival, and within less than a 24-hour period, she had to do interviews, had to attend a premiere, a party for her movie, The Yards, and then get back on a plane and go to London or New York, wherever she was shooting. She was on my plane. She looked just as good the next morning as she did when I interviewed her the day before. She really is beautiful.
She is. That's why we love to hate her.
Thanks, Lisa.
Bye.
Still to come on E! News Weekend.
I'm not into waiting. I'm not into a scene. I'm not into noise.
But she is into expressing herself. Where stars go to let loose, we'll show you their secret spots next. You ever wonder where the stars hang out? Where Mel Gibson parties? Where Gwyneth Paltrow sips tea? Or where George Clooney goes for dinner? Kristen Malia has been scouring Hollywood for the hippest hotspots, and now she shares her top picks with us.
Celebrity hotspots have been around since the early days of show business. Places like Chazen's drew a star-studded crowd back in the 40s and 50s. Today, the rich and famous have a lot more choices.
I like Cuban food and salsa music.
I absolutely love Indian.
I'm not into waiting. I'm not into a scene. I'm not into noise. I like really good food.
But in a town that makes and breaks careers, hip hangouts can become has-beens almost overnight. Still, several spots, like Mr. Chow's Beverly Hills restaurant, have maintained their star status over the years.
It's amazing food, number one. They have great food. So that helps.
The food, the cooks, the company. And it's nice when you go to Mr. Chow's, you know what you're going to get.
This is one of my favorite places to come. I never have to look at the menu. I know exactly what I want.
The food. I actually eat here. I probably eat here every couple weeks. I mean, I love it here.
It's a testament to Mr. Chow's that they're still here, still kicking up the very good food.
And Mr. Chow's been kicking it up for nearly 27 years. With regulars like George Clooney, Sylvester Stallone, and Tom Cruise, this former actor turned restaurateur thinks he knows why.
We try to create atmosphere where magic can happen. So it's a very spontaneous and very clubby in that sense.
For a more sedate outing, there's Elixir. It's a chic tea and herbal remedy spot in the heart of Hollywood.
So I know, since Elixir has been around, It's been kind of a celebrity hotspot. I've heard Gwyneth Paltrow, Winona Ryder, Hilary Swank, they've all been in here. Is this true?
They've been spotted, so I hear.
I also heard, though, that Gwyneth has meetings out in the garden area.
Well, she's been spotted talking to people. What's going on, we don't know.
And finally, if you don't mind waiting in line, you can stargaze at the new hip hangout, the Sunset Room.
Lenny Kravitz is in here often, Denzel Washington, Lauren Holly, Sylvester Stallone, Ben Affleck, Bruce Willis.
It's also played host to star-studded soirees like this one for the Party of Five cast, and recent private parties for the premieres of The Patriot and Sex and the City's new season. So whether you're a star or not, you can socialize like one. Hollywood has something for everyone. But don't wait too long. Your favorite hotspot may cool off in no time.
It's all so cyclical here, you'll succeed and have some longevity. If not, you know, you'll have some fun.
In Los Angeles, I'm Kristen Malia for E! News.
And here's what we're serving up next time on this hotspot we call E! News Daily. Watch out, Arnold. Action hero Jean-Claude Van Damme is kicking his way back to the top. His new movie, his new attitude, all on the next E! News Daily. From all of us here at E! News Weekend, thanks for watching. Remember, we're here every night at 6:30. I'm Steve Kometko. We leave you now with Maya performing her single, Case of the X, from her new album, Fear of Flying. And we'll see you next time.